It's a CBS2 exclusive investigation. Previously classified documents and other evidence pointing to a major hidden danger at the San Onofre nuclear power plant. CBS2's Randy Page has a story affecting everyone across the Southland.
Grace Fantilo was one of nearly 8.5 million people who live within 50 miles of the San Onofre nuclear generating station. In fact, her home on Avenida San Pablo in San Clemente is less than 5 miles from the twin reactor domes. Her feeling about the plant's safety?
It's an accident waiting to happen.
Fantilo isn't the only one who's worried about the plant. We've consulted with nuclear experts who tell us they're concerned about fire and the lessons learned 37 years ago at the Browns Ferry nuclear power plant in Athens, Alabama.
March 22, 1975.
This PBS documentary detailed the event when a worker using a candle to search for air leaks started a fire. It melted the main and backup cables needed to cool the reactor. In 1981, the NRC responded with fire regulations that require wiring for the main and backup systems to be physically separated at all nuclear power plants to prevent one fire from taking out both systems. Now, more than three decades later, San Onofre continues to be in violation of those decades-old fire safety standards.
Browns Ferry was an amazing wake-up call.
Dan Hirsch teaches nuclear policy at the University of California, Santa Cruz.
You have to prevent fires in reactors or you can have a meltdown. And you have to create significant separation between your backup and your primary cabling. The reactor in back of us still hasn't done that.
The NRC allows San Onofre to compensate for its failure to keep enough separation between the main and backup cables by hiring workers to conduct hourly fire inspections in areas where the cables are too close together. But some of those fire watches were never done. We've obtained this previously classified report, which shows one worker deliberately failed to conduct required fire protection surveillances and falsified fire watch logs. And the report says it went on for 5 years between the dates of April 2001 and December 2006. Then there's the 2009 case of another Firewatch employee who was observed smoking what appeared to be marijuana within the licensee's protected area. In both cases, the Firewatch employees were fired, but the NRC did not fine or discipline Edison for its part in failing to recognize 5 years of non-existent inspections. Through fire watches and other measures, San Onofre counts on its employees to maintain fire protection at the plant. So you might wonder if the utility also listens to its employees' safety concerns. Well, consider this. San Onofre leads the nation in the number of safety complaints filed by its own employees to the Nuclear Regulatory Commission.
Do you worry about the people who live near the plant?
Of course.
One of those safety complaints was filed by this electrical engineer who spent the last 11 of his 30 years in the nuclear industry at San Onofre. We have agreed not to reveal his identity.
Is this a dangerous plant?
At this point, it is a dangerous plant.
He says he told his managers back in 1999 about another fire risk, circuit breakers that could allow critical wiring connected to emergency pumps to overheat and catch fire. He says his supervisors ignored his concerns for years, so he went to the NRC.
You're talking about a very real risk of fire.
That is true, no question about that.
Last year, the NRC agreed the circuit breakers did not provide adequate protection, and Edison agreed to change them by the end of the year. Now, more than a decade after he first identified the problem, he's still waiting for confirmation that the work has been done.
If you put it all together for me, the safety culture of the plant, the known problems that have surfaced. In your professional view, is this a dangerous plant?
It is.
In its inspection reports, the NRC says San Onofre's violation of the 1981 fire protection standards is more than minor, but carries a very low risk significance because of the things plant workers are doing called operator manual actions and the low probability of fire damage. But other nuclear experts we consulted share Dan Hirsch's assessment.
It's a form of Russian roulette. It's a form of tossing dice.
Experts on both sides agree a nuclear power plant can never be 100% safe. The real question is, San Onofre safe enough? From the NRC's vantage point, the answer is yes. But the view from Grace Fantilo's backyard prompts a different conclusion.
It will never be safe enough.
In San Onofre, Randy Page, CBS 2 News.